original Barbie doll collection was created by Ruth Handler, who said she wanted kids around the world to feel they can be whoever they want to be. But over the years, countries around the world started creating alternatives to these Barbies that would embody the culture and represent their ethnicity. Wait until you see these dolls that were created to represent the Islamic values. You'll be amazed by this new definition of beauty. Make sure you never miss one of our videos by clicking the red subscribe button. Today, we are talking about 10 amazing Barbies from around the world. Build Lily Doll from Germany, aka the doll that started it all. Did you know that this doll wasn't intended for children at all? It was one of those joke gifts you would give to your best friend, and many would often get them as a present at their bachelorette party. It was sold in tobacco shops and bars, and it even had its own slightly inappropriate comic book. After a while, it finally sparked more interest with the children than it did with adults. The Build Lily doll was just 1 foot tall, it had bleach blonde hair, curves, and a lot of makeup. But little did the Germans know that this doll will soon take over the entire world. Well, sort of. The doll caught the eye of a 15-year-old Barbara Handler, whose mother was the co-founder of the Mattel Toy Company. They brought three of these dolls back home, and 3 years later, the very first Barbie doll collection was introduced at the American International Toy Fair in New York. Did you know that Barbie is actually named by Barbara Handler, who first saw the dolls in Germany? Many of the Build Lily dolls' features transferred onto the Barbie doll, although Ruth Handler seemed to improve a lot of things. This includes creating removable shoes and making sure the toy is seen more than just entertainment for adults. Muslim Barbie. This Barbie got a Muslim makeover that got everyone talking. It's called the Hijabi Barbie, and it was created by the 24-year-old Hanifa Adam from Nigeria. Hanifa simply wanted to create a Barbie doll that dresses the same way she did. And since the original Barbie collection doesn't feature Muslim Barbies, she decided to do the job herself. Hanifa went to the store, bought a doll, and started documenting her idea on an Instagram account she called Hijabi. Although the company behind Barbies brought new Barbie skin tones, eye colors, hairstyles, and body type to bring awareness to culture and diversity, we have yet to see Arabic dolls in their collection. This is because Barbie was actually outlawed in Saudi Arabia, as it promotes non-Islamic ideals. This is why Saudi Arabia created their own Barbie doll called Fula. She comes with her own prayer mat and a large range of accessories. Her clothing depends on where you buy her, and you can also find Fula in Egypt and Indonesia. Fula was originally released in 2003, but has proven to be a huge success. By 2005, 1.5 million Fula dolls were sold across the Middle East. Pulup, a Barbie doll from South Korea. Pulup dolls are a South Korean version of Barbie dolls. They're fashionable and completely customizable. A Pulup doll has a large head and big eyes, with a mechanism that makes them able to look from side to side, as well as blink. They were first introduced in 2003, and since then, a range of over 200 Pulup dolls has been released. They also come with a boyfriend, which was first released in 2004. His name is Namu, but unfortunately, he wasn't as popular as these little fashionistas. He got discontinued just a year later. Then, a new boyfriend came along called Taeyang, and this one is here to stay. The Pulup family also comes with a sister called Dal, a best friend Byul, younger brother Isul, and Yolum, who is Pulup's future daughter. The range keeps on developing, and new dolls are released almost every month. You can easily make your own Pulup and choose your custom eye color, change her hair, clothing, and body. The company behind Pulup also frequently releases limited edition dolls. It has even created a Sailor Moon doll, as well as other characters from the anime culture. Queens of Africa, dolls from Nigeria. In an attempt to bring awareness to the diversity of the original Barbie dolls, Nigerian entrepreneur Taufik Okoya created a new line of dolls back in 2007. These dolls highlight the diversity of skin tones and hair texture, all while rocking contemporary African fashion. They are called Queens of Africa. It only reconfirmed the need for diverse dolls when the Queens of Africa outsold the original Barbie dolls in 2014. Taufik was inspired to create these dolls after his own daughter expressed her desire to have the same skin tone as the original Barbie. He felt the need to educate young girls about the importance of being yourself, regardless of where you come from. The Queens of Africa's motto is to empower the African girl child. They're modeled after three main African tribes, and each queen has a different symbol. Love. peace, and endurance. And he's not stopping just at dolls. His team is also creating educational books that teach children self-confidence and cultural pride. They are also aiming to expand the doll line and include at least one doll for each African country, along with creating limited edition dolls to raise funds for an African education charity. Lottie Dolls from Ireland. Lottie Dolls are Ireland's alternative to the famous Barbie doll. With an aim to empower children to be themselves, the company behind Lottie Dolls created dolls that look like real 9-year-old children. These doll characters are completely relatable and age-appropriate. They represent different facets of childhood without any limitation. A Lottie doll comes with a diverse range of skin, hair, and clothing. The world they live in is called the Banksia Island, which is loosely based on UK's Brownsea Island, which is a birthplace of many famous storylines and movements, including Scouts and Girl Guides. The company behind the dolls spent months working with kids, their parents, child psychologists, and more to truly understand the children's world and their needs. They wanted to protect childhoods and stop children from wanting to grow up too soon. This is why a Lottie doll does not wear makeup and isn't wearing high heels. Lottie dolls also highlight women power. Their education resources include great women biographies for kids, which includes people like Jane Austen, Emily Dickinson, and Eleanor Roosevelt. To quote the company, "She can stand on her own 2 feet." Lottie's tagline is to be bold, be brave, be you. Lottie dolls from Ireland. Mompi Impopi from South Africa. With a mission to change beauty ideals and young women, Mate Magoba launched her line of Mompi Impopi dolls in June 2014. Unlike Barbie and other black dolls on the market, Mompi Impopi celebrates African girls' lush woolly hair, its coily curls, sun-kissed golden skin, and African fabulousness. These dolls took over a year to make. The founder says she is still trying to find new ways to feature their diversity to change the meaning of beautiful. The name behind the dolls comes from merging the meaning of the word doll in South Africa. Mate said she wants to open the minds of little girls and let them see and embrace their own beauty, without calling it exotic or dark beauty. These dolls portray the true African story, from how they dress to how their character will develop as the company expands. The founder hopes that Mompi Impopi will open up the African world to little girls around the world, as it is a country that is often misrepresented and misunderstood. The country is also looking into creating boy characters in hopes to let go of stigma that a doll is just a little girl's toy. Tree Change Dolls from Australia. These dolls are a little bit different, and their success was surprising even to their founder, Sonia Singh. Starting off as a craft project, Sonia is now fully devoted to the collection she calls Tree Change Dolls. These dolls have been rescued and recycled from various shops around Tasmania. Sonia swapped their previous lifestyle to something far more relatable and down to earth. She removed the factory paint and decided to give them what she calls a make-under by hand. Her mom, an expert knitter and sewer, created their clothing. Sonia documented her creations on her Tumblr blog, and soon her work started going viral and she got the world's attention. She said that she seems to have triggered a global conversation about the suitability and style of some children's toys. However, Sonia wants to keep the creativity in her project and refuses to mass produce it, as it would lose the meaning to the original idea. Instead of turning her work into a full-time company, Sonia wants other people to take action. She created a guide to how you can restyle your own dolls and has crochet and knitting patterns available on her Etsy site. Japan's Laika-chan. This 8-inch doll started taking over Japan in 1967. It was created by the Takara Company, whose motto is, "Playing is culture." Laika-chan is 11 years old, goes to junior high school, and has a variety of interests that have changed over the years. She's very family-oriented and has twin sisters and younger siblings that are triplets. Other versions of Laika-chan included a pregnant adult doll that was a tribute to Crown Princess Masako. She was at the time pregnant with her daughter, Aiko. Despite her young age, the Laika doll has several different career outfits and special editions, such as the famous Hatsumi Miku doll. One of the coolest Laika dolls ever is the award-winning triple-color change Laika-chan. The doll changes her hair color according to the temperature, but there's an even bigger mystery to this cute-looking doll. According to the urban legends, throwing away your Laika-chan means it will come back for revenge. Sara and Dara from Iran. Muslim Sara and Dara dolls were created with an idea to promote traditional pro-family backgrounds and modest clothing that's in line with Islamic values. They were introduced by the Institute for the Intellectual Development of Children and Young Adults, a government agency that works with the Ministry of Education. As Barbie dolls were pretty much foreign to Iran's culture, the public welcomed the new Iranian Barbie dolls. The Sara and Dara dolls are also featured in school books and stories, which are available to be purchased with the dolls. Sara and Dara, a boy and a girl, are 8-year-old siblings that are young enough to appear without a headscarf under the Islamic law. But despite that, all four models of these dolls do come with headscarves and two outfits. The toy makers said it took 5 years to create these dolls as they wanted to make sure the public will be just as enthusiastic about them as they are. For that exact reason, these dolls are actually produced in China, where modern technology is more advanced. But Iran does plan to bring quality technology into the country. Sara and Dara are a direct response to the popular Barbie and Ken, which are far more expensive in the country with an average monthly salary of $100. You can purchase these dolls for $15, while a Barbie doll will cost $40. Barbie's Around the World Collection. Mattel, the company behind the original Barbie doll, definitely hears the demands from their international customers. In an attempt to bring awareness to diversity and ethnicity, Mattel, the company behind the Barbie doll, created a series of Barbies around the world. These dolls embrace their ethnicity and show off the nation's traditional values. You can even find Hawaiian Barbie dolls, which come complete with a lei and a mumu, the traditional Hawaiian dress. The first African-American Barbie, called Christie, was created back in 1968, but it wasn't until 1980 that Mattel started expressing different cultures and nationalities through the Barbie dolls. 1980 was the year of the Italian Barbie, which belonged to the dolls of the World Collection. This collection currently represents more than 40 nations across all continents. But the problem remained, all Barbies were the same size. After all these years, and after a lot of feedback from nations around the world, Mattel has finally completely embraced the fact that people do come in different shapes, sizes, and skin colors. The true diversity and a shift in the Barbie doll production didn't come until 2016, when Mattel launched Fashionista Barbies. They are now available in 4 body types, 7 skin tones, 8 eye colors, and 18 hairstyles. And it paid off. The Barbie sales rose by 16% since the launch of the diverse Fashionistas collection. What's your favorite Barbie doll you've ever owned? Let us know in the comments below. Don't forget to click that thumbs up button and subscribe to never miss a video from us again. For more videos like this one, check out the amazing evolution of iconic children's toys. See you next time.